Hello, beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. It's me, I'm Fumi, and my channel is all about motivational topics, money making, marriage topics. So today, I'm going to be speaking on how to rekindle love in relationship and marriage. So I'm wearing love. How to continue to wear love in relationship and marriage, because love is one thing that keeps relationship and marriage going. So, but before I get into that, there is a song for this channel, and the song is to welcome the new viewers to this channel and to also thank existing subscribers. And the song is "We Are Going Ayao, 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 please subscribe to this channel. Press the notification bell. That way you get updates each time I upload new videos. So, how to rekindle love in relationship and marriage? Are you in that marriage that you think that your marriage, the light of love, it's not burning high like when you first got married? Or are you in that relationship now? You are dating and the light of love is not burning as you expect, right? As expected. So what are the things that you need to do to make sure that you keep your love life burning, your love light burning high and higher? Yes, love means different things to different individuals. What love means to you may be different compared to what love means to another person. So what love means to you may be different from what love means to me. I'm going to talk about the general things that you need to, that love means, and at the same time, the most important thing, specific things that love means to you. So, generally, what love means and what you need to do. Love is patience. You have to evaluate yourself and your spouse or your partner who is patient, because if they are in relationship and in marriage, there are two imperfect partner or spouse that are living for a perfect purpose. Your purpose is perfect. Your purpose is to live together in peace, in love, in harmony, to enjoy each other as partner in relationship or as spouse in marriage. So, love is patience. If patience is not up high in your relationship and in your marriage, then you need to rekindle love back into your marriage by boosting your patience. You have to be patient in listening to each other. You have to be patient in processing the thoughts when your spouse is telling you something, or when your wife is, or when your partner is discussing something with you. You have to be patient to understand what the message that is being passed across. You have to be patient in interpreting an action or deed. So to rekindle love back into your relationship, to ignite love back into your marriage, or to boost love in your relationship and marriage, you have to weigh the level of patience. You have to boost it up to ensure that the light of love is burning in your relationship. Another thing that you need to do to boost love into your relationship and into your marriage is to ensure that there is no competition. Competition from envy. It's good to compete when it comes to tournaments, when it comes to you see something good like health, you want to boost your health, your spouse is going on a journey of boosting or managing his or her health very well, you also want to ensure that you keep your health, because you want to be healthy to be alive, to enjoy the marriage and to enjoy the relationship as well. That is not a competition. That is not envy. It's just growing together. But when it comes to envy, don't be envious of each other. Good to recognize achievement of your spouse. Good to recognize achievement of your partner. Good to celebrate the achievement of your partner, the achievement of your spouse. But please, do not allow envy, because love does not grow where there is envy. The light of love does not burn high where there is envy. Love does not boast. Yes, like I said, good to do great things together. Good to grow together. And when you achieve something good, when you achieve something tangible, you can recognize it, but not to boast. Because love does not boast. If you want to rekindle love, if you want to reignite the love of the light of love in your relationship and in your marriage, you have to ensure that there is no boast. You are not boasting. Your spouse is not boasting. Your wife is not boasting. Even you yourself, you are not boasting. Because love does not grow where there is boast. Love does not proud. Oh, love grows and works stronger in an environment where there is humility. Where there is humility. Keep the light of love burning on a high level with sense of humility. Oh, be respectful. Acknowledge each other. Be with each other. Encourage each other, because love does not proud. The pride kills the light of love in relationship and in marriage, and because it does not bring respect. Another thing that you want to ensure to keep the light of love burning in your relationship and in your marriage is to ensure that you are not entertaining pride. You are not rude to each other, because pride is rude. Pride is rude. There's no respect. Respect must be mutual between each other. Respect your spouse and let your spouse will respect you. Remember, you cannot force respect. You can earn respect. So if you want to get respect from someone, you have to give respect. It is all about giving and receiving. Giving and receiving. That is all about respect, because it is mutual. If you don't give, what you don't give, you don't get it. What you don't give, you have, and you cannot give it. So you have to ensure that you respect yourself first, you respect your partner, you respect your spouse, you respect yourself so that your spouse can respect you back. Respect must be mutual. Respect is another thing that you can use to rekindle love, to reignite love in your relationship and in your marriage. Very important. Love does not self-seeking. In relationship, if you want to keep the light of love burning in your relationship, in your marriage, you have to ensure that you are selfless, because love is selfless. Let the light of love be burning high, being selfless. Be able to be there for your spouse. Be able to be there for your partner at any time. It is being selfless does not make less of you. It's just a sacrifice. When you are with someone that you love, you have to ensure that you are selfless for the person. You are being there for the person when the person is the person can be there for you. Remember, today my shirt, I'm wearing love. To wear love in your relationship, ensure that you are wearing love. You are wearing love. Everything about you demonstrate love. Everything about you shows love. Your action, your deed, your thoughts shows love. Yes. To keep the light of love burning, to reignite love, to rekindle love in your relationship and in your marriage, you have to wear love. You have to exude love out of you in thought, in deed, in action. You have to be selfless. Selfless means consideration. Giving consideration to your spouse, to your partner, so that you can keep the light of love burning, to rekindle love in your relationship and in your marriage. Those are the things that you have to pay attention to ensure that you keep the light of love burning in your relationship and in your marriage. Another thing is that to rekindle love, to reignite love, to keep the light of love burning in your relationship and in your marriage, you have to ensure that you keep anger away. Because love does not grow where someone easily gets angered. Oh, love does not easily angered. Yes, you have to ensure that peace, maintain peace at all times. Even if something is wrong, correct in love, not with anger. You can pass a message that can stick, that can resonate, that can correct someone in love, not in anger, not in anger, not in a rude way. Because whatever we say in a rude way, it flies off easily. But whatever we say out of love, it sticks with us, it resonates with us, it becomes part of us, and we become self-aware of it when something like that wants to happen again. So to keep the light of love burning in your relationship and in your marriage, and to reignite love in your relationship and in your marriage, you have to let peace reign. Love does not get angered easily. Keeps record of wrong. Oh, love does not keep records of wrong. That is why you have to let go. Yes, because you are two imperfect people that have come together to stay together for a perfect purpose. Your purpose for now, if you are in a relationship, is to get into marriage. And when you are married, your purpose is to live a lovely life, is to achieve goals together, to live a purposeful living. So how will you do that if you are keeping the records of wrong? You have to let go. It is okay to get offended by what your partner did or by what your spouse did, but you have to let go. Love keeps no record of wrong. So let go, forgive, and keep the light of love burning. Higher, higher we shall go. Yes, remember, you have to wear love as I'm wearing love. Yes, you have to wear love. And to wear love, you have to forgo record of wrongs. Yes, love does not delight in evil. Yes, love does not delight in evil. If you are not a magician, if you are not a comedian, you don't need to prank yourself. You do not need to delight yourself in evil. Some pranks are evil. Love does not keep records of wrong things, remember. And at the same time, please do not delight yourself in doing evil things. A mistake that is repeated multiple times, it's no longer a mistake. It's you, it's part of you. So we have to ensure that we are not delightful in evil things. We are, if whatever we do that is wrong, once our spouse or our partner call our attention to it, we have to ensure that it does not repeat itself. Once we keep repeating wrong things day in, day out, that means that we are delightful in doing the wrong thing. We have to understand that to ignite love, to rekindle love in our relationship and in our marriage, love does not delight in evil things. We cannot. The light of love, the candle of love, cannot keep burning high when we are doing evil things. So another thing is that we have to rejoice with the truth. Rejoice with the truth. Be honest. That is where I'm going. I do not want to slam into our face like, yes, honesty, trustworthy. The trust is the foundation of marriage. It builds love. When there is trust, there is no reason for doubt. There is no reason for fear. There is no reason for abuse. Yes, love, 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 love. To keep the light of love burning in our relationship and in our marriage, we have to ensure that we rejoice with the truth. In all things that we do, we must be truthful. Let's be truthful in our thoughts, in our deed, in our action. Yes, to rekindle love. How to rekindle love in relationship and in our marriage? Love. Love. It is all about love. It is all about unity. When we are delightful in truth, when we are delightful, when we rejoice in truth, yes, the candle of love will be burning high. The candle of love will be higher in our life. So What are the things, specific things, like I said earlier, what are the specific things that love means to all of us? Yes, specifically, every woman wants protection from their spouse, either from the inner side or from outside against danger. Every woman wants protection. They want their spouse to protect them. But I want to implore the spouse, please do not be overprotected. Yes, because let them be free. Some women have been overprotected that they are not free to achieve their purpose. They are not free to achieve the calling, what they've been created to do. So when it comes to protection, yes, every woman desires to have protection. And it is one of the responsibility that a man should protect his family. Aside from providing for them, a man must protect them as well. So every woman desire to protection. So love protects. Love always protects. To rekindle love in relationship and in marriage, love protects. Love protects. Love hopes. Love persevere. And love never fails. So in order for you to wear love in your relationship, to rekindle love, to reignite love in your relationship, and to keep the light of love burning, remember, you have to be patient. Love does not envy. Love does not boast. Love does not proud. Love does not rude. Love does not self-seeking. Love does not keep record of wrongs. Love does not delight. Does not delightful in evil things. Love rejoices with the truth. So love always protects. Love always trusts. And love always hopes. Love always persevere. And love never fails. So additionally, know what love means, especially to your husband or to your wife or to your partner, and make sure you do. Some women, they love to be celebrated. They like the publicity. Give it to her if that is what she wants. Some women want some specific gift that makes them happy. Please give it to her if that is what makes her happy. Some men, they like public affirmation. If that is what makes your partner or your spouse to feel loved, please keep the light of love burning by giving public affirmation. Thank you so much. This is all I have for you today. And if you're new to this channel, you just come across this channel for the first time, please subscribe, press the notification bell. That way you get notice each time I upload new video. And to my existing subscribers, I say thank you. Thank you for being my subscriber and for remaining my subscriber. And the song for this channel, I want to sing it now to encourage and to motivate all of us. And the song is, we are going ayao, 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 we are going ayao, oh ayao, oh ayao, never fails. Keep loving. Keep igniting the love. Keep the candle of love burning high and high in your relationship and in your marriage. Till I come your way next time, remain blessed.